Breaking, George Soros gets horrible news, it's now official. It looks like Hungary has had enough of George Soros' attempts to force his leftist agenda on the nation. According to The Times, Viktor Orban, Prime Minister of Hungary, ordered his intelligence agencies to investigate the empire of George Soros, as he ramps up his efforts to stop Soros' agenda. Soros, a billionaire who finances hard-left causes worldwide, has targeted Hungary because of its refusal to allow unlimited numbers of immigrants to enter its borders. Hungary's intelligence agencies are investigating Soros because of his efforts to have the European Union punish the nation for standing against the EU's mixed population initiative. In an interview, Prime Minister Orban predicted that Europe will be split between a migrant-free zone and other Western nations who fail to deport undocumented immigrants. The European Union has used its power to force nations to accept a seemingly unlimited number of immigrants from foreign countries, especially from the Middle East. The enforcement of these lax immigration policies has caused a myriad of problems in several European nations. Indeed, it is one of the reasons why the United Kingdom voted to leave the EU. Hungary is currently conducting a 7-week consultation in which citizens fill out a questionnaire asking whether or not they support the Soros plan. The plan is described as a strategy that involves flooding Europe with immigrants. The billionaire financier has urged European nations to take in 1 million immigrants per year. Elections are set to take place soon, and Orban's Fidesz party has increased its voting base by 59%. This shows that his focus on protecting Hungary's borders is resonating with the people. He has launched an aggressive campaign against Soros' agenda, going so far as to erect billboards featuring a picture of the billionaire with a message telling Hungarians to not let Soros have the last laugh. In an appearance on Hungarian radio on Friday, Orban slammed Soros' Open Society network, accusing them of driving an aggressively pro-immigration agenda in an effort to eliminate the culture and Christian identity of European nations. The Soros network has an extensive sphere of influence within the European Parliament and other EU bodies, Orban said, and its aim is to build a Europe of mixed population and to condemn the Hungarian government for opposing their view on migration. Orban also stated that during last week's summit in Brussels, he had to fight an uphill battle to oppose policies that would force Hungary to relinquish its sovereignty. There was a great deal of pressure on me to compromise on migration, he said. The Prime Minister has continually argued that each European nation should have the right to establish its own immigration laws. He rightly believes that these countries should not be subject to the rule of bureaucrats in Brussels. Orban insists that Europe needs to preserve its Christian culture in order to survive, which is why he fights so aggressively against Soros' efforts. Orban's willingness to stand against the efforts of people like George Soros is refreshing, especially when considering the fact that most European nations have allowed the European Union to dictate their immigration policies. This failed approach to immigration has caused serious problems for the affected nations. It hardly seems that a week can pass by without the media reporting another radical Islamic terrorist attack on European soil. Belgium, France, Germany, and the United Kingdom are some of the countries that have been targeted by terrorist groups like the Islamic State, ISIS. Simply put, the EU's forced immigration policies are killing people, but even more than that, they are contributing to the demise of European culture. Hopefully, more European leaders will follow Orban's example.